Just a few of the sounds that I have been able to create with this brand new Fender Tone Master Pro and the Pro Control software, which is a good looking piece of editing software for the Mac, and I would imagine Windows as well, and it's basically a direct reflection of what is happening down here on the screen, which is very nice. It means that you don't have to kind of confuse interfaces. I love that. This is a preset that I've written called Berg Vibro King, because it's based around the mighty Fender Vibro King amplifier from Fender, which has got a 3x10 cabinet in it, and it's pretty much a kitchen sink preset, which I've already uploaded to the Pro Control cloud, so you can give it a shot as well. It works quite well. I voiced it actually with this Stratocaster, but I've just been mucking around with this PA28 Charvel, which is Prashant Aswani's signature model, which I love, and it's working great with these PA28 humbuckers too. So let's have a quick look at it, shall we? And I'll use the screen software here. You can see it says assignments modified. That's because every time I touch something here, it's telling me that I'm modifying it on the hardware, which is totally cool. So here's our Fender Vibro King settings. Now that's pretty hot with the humbuckers in it, so I might want to back it off a little. And just like the real Vibro King, you've got a fat control. So if you want a little more grunt, give the fat control a go, and we can get out of there just by hitting anywhere on the blank screen or exit. I've got right up the front in terms of the signal path, I've got a Dynacomp, which exhibits all of the charms and some of the lesser charms of the real thing, but you know, I kind of like that because I grew up with them. Next to it, I have a 808, which they call the green box. Again, there's our notification telling me that I've modified it on the hardware here. And the settings I've given it are basically a lot of level, not much drive, and a little bit of tone, and full 100% blend. And it's driving that Vibro King very well. Next to it is the OD1R, which is the Nobel. So I can stack them for a bit more grunt. Then we've got the classic vibe. You you know, and if you put the 808 or something in front of it. You can get bluesy all night long. To the right of the amp, or after the amplifier, is the good old 3D chorus, which I'm guessing is the Dimension D. And interestingly, you can choose any of the combinations of the four buttons on the Dimension D. For instance, I might want two and four. Which is quite beautiful, so you can play around with those. To its right, we've got the old memory delay, otherwise known as the memory man. And you can see that apart from the time left and right and the tap divisions, all that really good stereo stuff, there's another page with depth, gain and grit. Do you find that on the original? Perhaps you do. You've also got controls for spillover or not. And interestingly, the presets actually spill into each other. So it's almost like a gapless preset kind of thing, because the reverbs and stuff will just flow beautifully in from one preset to the other. And I love that. Rotary. There's a couple of different rotaries. Again, this one's got two pages of controls, so you've got a ramp control, sense control, dynamics on or off. I haven't gone there yet, so I'm not quite sure exactly how they work, but the sound on its own is pretty darn good. Add a little bit of delay. Maybe ramp it up with a bit of 808. And then finally, we've got the reverb at the end. So that's the Berg Vibro King preset, and you can download that and tweak it to your taste, as you should, from the Pro Control Cloud. Let's have a look at a couple of other ones here that I've created. I've got one here called Berg 2 Amps. Called 2 Amps because one of those amps is, as you see, the classic Princeton, and the other one is the classic Plexi. Switch that reverb off, it's a bit much. Keep the delay. Again, the delay is the old memory delay, or the memory man delay. There's a whole heap of really good delays in here, actually. Let's have a quick look at a couple of them. For instance, if we choose the stereo space delay, you'll see that it comes up and it looks like the old green rack of yore. And it has three pages of controls, not dissimilar to the controls that you would find on the real thing, which is cool. And again, I've complemented those two amps with various different drives. And the Dimension D and the compressor. Now that delay's got a fair bit of mix in it, so if I bring it up here on the actual hardware interface, I can then go and turn that mix control down, either with the foot switch knob or with the recreations of the real thing. There we go, that's a bit tamer. So look, there's a quick look at a couple of presets. Both of those, plus more of mine, are up on the Pro Control website or the community page, however you choose to call it. And, you know, Pro Control is in its infancy. So is the software for the Tone Master Pro, but it's great. It's running stably. I'm not getting any dropouts or anything with USB. Everything's connecting beautifully and it sounds good. I really like the Tone Master Pro. It's got 30 plus amps in it already in firmware version 1 and a whole stack of really kind of obviously usable effects because they look like the real thing. So instantly there's that familiarity with the actual real world devices, which is a good thing. Yeah, there'll be more from me on this guy. It's a cool machine, and I'm having a lot of fun with it, and it sounds good, which is the main thing. Fender Tone Master Pro. See you soon.